Welcome back, children, to third part of Ceiling to the Stars. So far, what have we seen? That the poet Ashley is trying to go for an adventure, and that is out of space, which means universe. Secondly, in the second paragraph, in the second stanza, what did we see, children? We had seen that he is planning to go to two planets. And which two are they? They are Mars and Saturn. Now, what do we see? Now, what is he trying to tell us finally? He says, "For now, though, I'll stay put. Mom said lunch is at noon. But after that, I'll take off. My ship is in my room." What is the poet trying to tell us, children? What is this stay put, ship and all that? Let us see. The first line, "For now, though, I'll stay put." Now that the poet is wondering where to go next, he is planning to pause for a while. By stay put, he means be in the same place and not move. We must know why he wants to hold on in the same position for a while. Is it that he is hungry and wants to grab something quickly and then think and plan better? I wonder what will come next, food or planning of other destination? Mom said, "Lunch is at noon." Why did the poet say that he will have to be in the same place? Now we know it was for lunch. His mother reminds him that it was time for some food, so he would need to put a pause to his thoughts. How many of you have meals together with your family? We must learn to have our food together. There is a saying, "People who eat together live together." Actually, that's the time when all of us come together and then back to work. Next he says, "But after that, I'll take off." Look at the poet who is still determined to complete his trip to the outer space. I suppose if it was not lunchtime, he would have still continued on with the planning of moving out to the space. He doesn't want to give up on his joyful and thrilling journey. Do you feel he would somehow gulp down his food? Do you feel he would not enjoy his meal? Oh, how he wishes he didn't have to waste his time on food. "My ship is in my room." He is concluding by saying, "My ship is in my room." Here, by ship, he means spaceship, a vehicle that carries people or things to the moon and the planets. Poet tells us that even if he is at home, he can easily visit the outer space as the imaginary spaceship is already at home. Now, children, the lesson that we must learn from this poem is that no matter under what circumstances we are, we must not stop our efforts to reach our goal and achieve whatever we want. It is time for the poet to have lunch and relax, but he is all set to move on. So, children, with this, we come to the end of the poem. I hope you've understood and we've learned something really good out of it. Thank you.